Hey, welcome back to Who Me Be a Leader. And, you know, last time Cynthia got out of control with this whole procrastination thing. So we had to do a two-parter. And I'm just excited to be back. And I'm excited to have her here with me so we can finish up our topic of procrastination. Because we talked about some things off screen when we talked about, you know, the whole sitting in the middle of that thing. And the reason why it's silent, because a lot of times we don't know when it's going to strike and how quickly it strikes us.
Again, the other thing in the silent part of it is just us being silent about it.
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
what has been the biggest
don't
thing
want
with
to admit
us.
It. Yeah, don't
not
want.
Admitting that mm-hmm. there is a procrastination issue in there. Women particularly suffer from the fact that they realize when they tell you about it, you ain't going to accept it,
mm-hmm.
and you're going to take her through something when she tell you that.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
she ain't willing to even go through that. So guess what happened? Shut down.
Yeah.
And so also in the middle of all of that, she loving you in the middle of it.
Yeah.
She just hating your ways.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
I don't know if y'all have ever dealt with that in your marriage, that you love your partner, but you hate their ways.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And there's nothing you can do, obviously, about it because you done brought it to their attention. They won't change it. They always got excuses why it's being done.
Mm-hmm.
And never saying, okay, I'm going to do better and do better. Just never doing that, right?
But then you got them men that would admit that they procrastinate us.
You sure do have that.
But the fact is, nothing changes.
Correct. Wanting sympathy. Wanting sympathy.
Wanting sympathy.
I've seen that too. I've seen guys do that.
Because you know what? There's really, when I tell people this all the time, and a lot of times people don't get this. There is some arrogancy in admitting that you have an issue and not doing anything about it.
It really is.
You know, because we think that makes us look good that we can admit our issues.
Yes, sir, especially Christians.
It's not the admitting part to me. It's the doing part to me.
Yeah, it is.
Because the scripture tells us don't be just what hearers, but also be doers. So the fact is that, yeah, I could say, Cynthia, you know, I'm a procrastinator. Okay, now, we our thing is, okay, how are we going to be responsible now? Because mm-hmm. now that you've admitted it to me that you're a procrastinator, are you saying that so I can hold you accountable?
Correct.
Are you just saying it because it looks good to say
well,
it?
Well, and then you can go back and tell people, I told her I was a procrastinator.
Right, right, right. But okay, that's because the reason why I'm saying that is because we got some women out there who men have admitted that they procrastinate.
Yeah, they have.
But ain't nothing still haven't changed.
I know it's a problem.
And it is a problem. And that's what I'm saying, man. If you want your wife to respect you,
ooh, Lord.
Because that's the key word, respect, because
mm-hmm.
that's what
the
scripture
tell
a wife to do is to respect. But if you want your wife to respect you,
correct.
Then the fact is you need to mean what you say and say what you mean.
Oh, my God.
Because that's one of the difficult things to get men to do today
mm-hmm.
is to say what they mean and mean what they say. They're all over the place. For the mean of not wanting to be nailed
exactly.
down, they just kind of skirt around
correct.
The issues.
Correct.
And
now,
and
let me tell you something. They're getting very tired of it. Now, I'm going to tell you something bigger than that. The church has failed you.
Yeah. Yeah.
You procrastinating guys, the church has failed you as a Christian.
Mm.
Because let me show you how it has failed you and your wife. Your wife, I already know it has failed her, because when she's tried to bring it to anybody's attention,
mm-hmm.
they've tried to excuse you.
Mm.
By saying, at least he don't this.
Yeah.
At least he don't that.
Yeah.
And he's a good guy. He's so sweet. Oh, he's sweet.
Well, you know, I our motto to that good guy thing. He may be good, but he may not be good for you.
Exactly.
So that's the thing about it.
I mean, seriously. And it's not helping you to excuse you. That
no.
is one of the sickest no. things I have seen in a long time. And when I say I hear this from Christian pastors, Christian people
mm-hmm.
about people that have problems, they excuse you
right.
and it is not helping you for me not to be honest about your procrastination and how it's affecting your home.
Yeah.
It is just sad that as Christians we do each other
and
that.
Even affecting see this is a thing that I see that's going on today. As a matter of fact, one of the things that the guy was talking about when I went to church today, because he's dealing with the Beatitudes, and he said, blessed are those who are merciful. The thing about it is this, is that when we excuse a person away, Because God has put in his word for us to hold each other accountable. People are always talking about we judging folk when we hold them accountable.
I know it.
And that's the whole misunderstanding. So what happens is that when a person is saying I'm judging them all the time, what that does to a home, it backs a wife up.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm
saying?
And trust me when I say a lot of men know what they're doing. Because they know what they're doing. Mm-hmm. See, when I tell you, you judging me all the time, and see, what's going to happen is, I'm going to get tired of hearing that.
Absolutely.
And so what I'm going to do?
Shut
because
down.
I'm going to get this battle from you all the time.
Shut down.
That's what I'm going to do.
That's where the silence comes.
Yeah, yeah.
The silence is coming in the shutdown.
Yeah.
Because that's what we do with each other when we can't get you to understand.
Right.
But I'm telling you, as Christian men, there's not, it's not for me to make you understand. Mm-hmm. The word of God makes you understand and convicts you.
Yeah.
When you already know you're not doing what you should.
And you know. You know who you are.
You do.
We're not here to beat up on men. We just
exactly.
trying to bring some awareness of this situation.
And bring you to a more effective state
yeah.
in your position
yeah.
as a man. You
yeah.
need to take responsibility for yourself.
Yeah, because based on 2 Timothy 3:16, it say the word of God is inspired by God, good for reproof and correction.
Absolutely.
And it says that each man can be adequate and equipped
mm-hmm.
when he's corrected and reproved.
Correct.
Now, the thing that we got to understand as men, we got to learn how to receive from our wives.
Oh, my God.
Because that's a whole nother topic
oh,
right there.
Oh, my God, it is.
That's a whole nother topic. Trying to receive from your wife.
I know,
you know,
God.
And then you got them that won't receive, and you got them receiving too much. That they can't
exactly.
make no decision. That they taking all the information from
ain't
the wife.
The truth, Lord.
And she end up what? Making the decision.
Sure does. He said, she got it.
And see, that's that whole passive thing. See, but men have a way of skirting out
oh
of that stuff.
Oh, my God. You don't even need to get me started on that. Because I can talk about how they skirt around that. And I mean, literally, I've seen men do this.
Yeah. Yeah.
They have made their wives believe that they doing something. I got to laugh on that, y'all.
Yeah.
Cause I'm
yeah.
telling y'all, it
yeah.
is just hilarious.
Yeah. Yeah.
The stuff I've seen men doing when they have been living in the shadows of
yeah.
their wife.
Yeah.
And then when they get out, they want to act like they running something.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know what? We laugh about this. But the fact this is a serious
oh
matter.
My God, when it comes to the women,
when I
counsel women with tears in their
yeah,
eyes,
yeah.
it is tragic.
It's a serious
it's
matter.
It's tragic, right?
And the thing that we have to understand, and we're addressing men because this is a man's blood. We're addressing men because God dealt with you first.
Yes.
God dealt with you first.
Yes.
Remember 11:3, it gives the structure of the home. And the structure is Christ being the head of man.
Yes.
Man the head of woman, and God being the head of all. So when you keep that structure in place, because you
yes.
should be bearing most of the burden.
Yes, indeed.
You should be bearing because you have the capacity. God made you both physical capacity-wise and both emotional and
mentally, practical-wise and mental-wise.
And so what we're saying, man, is that you're going to have to step up.
Yeah,
you're going to have to step
you
up.
Must
and
do
and
it.
The reason why you're getting a lot of
family.
You're getting a lot of women that are backing up on you because you think they strong because they want to be. And I'm
Please
saying
say
they strong because they have to be.
That's what
you got to understand. And hey, look here, I'm going to have Cynthia back on here because the fact is this thing can get real crazy because when we get to talk about these issues
yes,
in these homes, man, it just flares up some things.
Yes,
hey, until we see you next time, may God bless you and keep you is our prayer. Bye-bye.